There are so many endless ideas for creating the most adorable nursery. It can be overwhelming, but have no fear. In this video, I'm going to share with you my personal 10 steps to decorating a nursery that is not only fabulous looking, but set up for positive mental and physical health and sprinkled in with a bit of kindness and compassion. Crib mattresses. Hands down, for me, the most important item you bring into a newborn's nursery is their mattress. So I'm going to spend a bit of time talking about it. The average child spends up to 75% of their younger years sleeping, and a baby's skin, just like ours, is porous, just like a sponge. And things like dangerous chemicals can easily pass through our skin. Manufacturers are allowed to sell crib mattresses that contain these highly dangerous chemicals. Chemicals that potentially affect a fragile baby's brain development. How crazy is that? Stay away from mattresses that are filled with these poisons. Also, allergic materials like latex, even if it's natural or organic latex, should never ever be used in a crib mattress. Because you don't know if a baby is allergic to latex because they were just born. Think of balloons. They're made of latex and they're not allowed in schools. Why? Because some kids are allergic to them and can have severe, dangerous reactions. Here's what's crazy. There are many, many organic, natural crib mattresses on the market stuffed with latex. Be careful. Hygiene and waterproofing. All those lovely liquids a baby expels, yuck, can contaminate a mattress below the surface, which can be breathed in by a baby when laying face down. Scary stuff. Although it's important to get an organic crib mattress, most do not have waterproofing. Not good and very, very necessary. Speaking of organic, do not be misled by words like bamboo and soybean. Those mattresses are filled with chemicals. Choose certified organic cotton. So make sure to get a crib mattress that is waterproof, without the use of harsh chemicals, is certified organic cotton, and certified non-toxic. Okay, on to decorating a nursery. Big pieces first. Choose the most important and largest pieces of furniture first. The crib, the dresser, changing table, the rocker, and if you're nursing, a nursing station. Make sure that the furniture is certified as sustainable and non-toxic. I suggest to go simple in colors and finishes on these large items because they can be expensive. You might think a bright gold dresser is really fun now, but in a year you might look at it like, huh, what the heck was I thinking? Energy. What kind of environment do you want for your baby? Do you want them to be independent thinkers, have a love of animals, embody their heritage? Then choose art and accessories that reflect that energy. Materials. Don't be afraid to mix the patterns of materials such as sheets, decorative pillows, and curtains. It's interesting and it's creative. If you're looking to create a neutral, clean-looking nursery without much color, then make sure you use different textures of the same whites. Make sure the fabrics you choose are certified as organic, non-toxic, and non-animal based. No leather, no down, wool, or silk. Walls. Choose a non-toxic, eco-friendly paint or wallpaper. Many paints and wallpapers contain very dangerous chemicals that off-gas, meaning that they release gases into the air that a fragile baby should never ever be near. As far as color of walls, I suggest a soft color, nothing too strong. Colors are very powerful and affect our moods and development. Curtains and flooring. Make sure that the curtains you install are safe for a baby, no dangling cords, and that the curtains are secured enough so they can't be pulled down by curious little hands. Curtains can have a pattern if the walls are simple. However, if the walls are busy with decals or a busy wallpaper, then go simple in your curtains. Don't overdo. It's tacky and it can be too much stimulation for a baby. Of course, your fabrics must be non-toxic and non-animal based. No wool or silk. For the floor, get a cheap, certified organic cotton rug since it will be destroyed by a baby. You can then switch it out without the guilt of its cost. Don't ignore the ceiling. Babies spend a lot of time on their backs. Paint the ceiling a color using non-toxic paint, of course, and add something that makes your little one giggle or smile. A funny face, a baby animal decal, something positive. Storage. You can never, ever have enough. Any piece of furniture you buy, if possible, should have some sort of storage, from a small table by a nursing station to an ottoman. Ceiling fan, get one. Fact, infants who sleep under a ceiling fan reduce their risk of SIDS by 72%. I know they are not the prettiest things. Get the simplest one that blends in as much as possible. It's a really, really important thing to get. Less is more. If the nursery looks a bit bare, better, because in the blink of an eye, a baby's needs will be changing, which means their nursery will have to match those needs. Think of a nursery like a transformer. Remember to be practical in decorating a nursery, and with each purchase, don't only think of aesthetics, but consider chemicals and kindness. And if you have to choose price over quality, don't skimp on a baby's mattress. Remember, it is the most important item in a nursery. And have fun!